Behavioral Science in the College of Nursing at the University of Illinois at Chicago. Her research program is focused on important cardiovascular health outcomes associated with hazardous and excessive alcohol consumption. Recent research includes the examination of cardiovascular risk in young adults with a history of binge drinking. In 2002, she appeared in the British Broadcasting Corporation documentary, Booze, Last Orders. Dr. Fennell is in Oak Park and has two sons who graduated from Oak Park with the Forest High School. We're happy to have you here.
Standard drink for Midland of General U.S. Please notice that blue bars represent our ORPRI students, so both our freshmen and juniors are drinking at much higher levels compared to their Illinois and U.S. comparison. Now, what is the national trend among high school students? So let me just tell you, our teenagers are binge drinking. This is the most common pattern of drinking. They're not sitting around the campfire sipping Chardonnay. One of three high school students reported six or more alcoholic beverages on one occasion. So this is actually higher. We defined binge drinking, but there's recent data that does suggest that they're drinking way more than 4 or 5, but they're up around 6 to 8 drinks per drinking occasion. And the average number of times per week is about 2 times, and the other proliferation I observed over the last decade are these drinking games, you know, beer pong, and it was disturbing. One of my sons attends the University of Delaware, and we first took him to the grocery store. The first thing I almost literally walked into and knocked over was the big display for beer pong. And I thought we all started laughing that, you know, I almost fell and knocked over the beer pong display. So I find it to be very disturbing. And also, you see that our teenagers like to use different devices and equipment to get the alcohol in as fast as they can, which can be deadly. Now, there are also some important gender or sex differences, and when you look at alcohol use in the past 30 days, and we focus on our high school age group, which are those between 14 and 18 years of age, you can see just as many boys as girls report to drinking within the last 30 days. What is a little disturbing, though, is when you dive into the different drinking patterns, you look at binge drinking, girls that are between 12 and 14, so this is getting into 7th and 8th grade, are reporting that they binge drink more than boys. I'm not sure what the reason for that is. When we look at racial and ethnic differences, we can see our white children are drinking at higher rates compared to their age match, black or African American teenager. Now, what are some of the consequences of underage drinking? Some of these are similar to consequences related to marijuana use. And again, let me really, really emphasize here. There is no level or amount of alcohol drinking that has any helpful or any kind of positive effect in individuals that are less than 35 years of age. Underage drinking is associated with three leading causes of death among our youth. That is unintentional injuries, homicides, and suicides. Engaging in sexual behaviors, dating violence, alcohol poisoning, drug overdoses, increased involvement in crimes and fighting, as well as poor judgment and decision-making. Now, I think all parents will all agree with me that right now, our children that are in high school, their judgment and decision-making, even without drinking, is not so great, okay? So, to put alcohol on top of this is really just complicating the situation. We've already heard that we have very solid science that indicates that there is still neuronal brain growth and maturation that is happening through 25 years of age, which makes this growing brain more vulnerable to the adverse effects of both alcohol and other drugs. There is data that shows that there is brain impairment, which actually is defined or means that there's decreased ability to learn new information and actually form new memories, perform cognitive functions. There's again testing and we come to a lot of data that indicate that these kids have difficulty performing very simple math problems or have the inability to read a roadmap. And we know that prolonged exposure produces one lasting neurophysiologic changes in the cortex and the hippocampus. Now, the hippocampus is the part of the brain that is responsible for learning and memory. And again, we have several studies that use very sophisticated techniques like CT scans to show that the hippocampus of young drinkers is about 10% smaller compared to their non-drinking teenage age-matched counterpart. Now, what are some myths about underage drinking and potential solutions? So I love this one. I get a lot of parents always saying to me, you know, we should really treat like Europeans, and we should lower the drinking age to 18 years, because this will foster less reckless and irresponsible drinking. And that is an absolute myth. If we look at our European teenagers, in every nation except Turkey, they drink more alcohol and engage more in repeat alcohol use than their American counterparts. So this is actually showing you a chart. You may not be able to see it really clearly. But when we look at teenagers, European teenagers, you'll see that, again, their rates of drinking more alcohol and engaging in more risky alcohol use is much higher. Actually, globally, we are at 22%. We're actually ranked like 25th. So this is a clear message that this is not the solution. And again, it relates to the fact that they're not just sitting around slowly sipping a beer or a Chardonnay. Another question that comes up is, well, you know, drinking youth is not linked to alcohol abuse or alcoholism. Again, we think that because these young parents are growing, that they are not only more vulnerable to some of the adverse neurophysiologic changes, but they're actually maybe more vulnerable to developing alcohol addiction. And again, there's data to support this. 40% of alcoholics began drinking before the age of 15 years, while about 10% began drinking at the age of 21 to 22%. I understand that binge drinking is a problem and leads to risky health behaviors, but regular drinking by a teenager is not. Again, that is false. We have data that suggests that high school students that report current drinking, but not binge drinking, also have an increased risk of engaging in risky behaviors. So again, getting at a very important point, any kind of moderate or low level of drinking is not really the solution. This is another one I ask the favorite ones. Our sons and daughters can go to war at the age of 18, so my gosh, they ought to be able to drink. Well, parents, what's wrong with us? Why are we allowing our kids to go to war at age 18? I have a problem with that. The drinking problem and the binge drinking problem is out of control. And as a parent, I cannot do anything. And I can tell you myself, my family and my life, I've been challenged with this too, and it's hard not to get worn down. But as you've already heard from our first speaker, parents, you have a very large, very important influence on your kids' decisions to drink and use drugs. You really, really do. And again, we have data that demonstrates there is, in fact, a downward trend in underage drinking, except, guess where? On college campuses. There's no parents on college campuses. And that's really a whole set, it's obviously a very important and related issue. Not allowing and not monitoring for alcohol use in your home does decrease drinking levels. Not allowing and monitoring for alcohol, yes. So not allowing, taking a firm stance and monitoring for alcohol use is an effective strategy. Can I do with other parents? I tried to do this among my friends, you know, said we tried to form a really unpacked. We're gonna kind of help and communicate with each other if you know something is going on. And we try to be careful about that and let each parent sort of talk to their kid about it. But we kind of try to have a united front on this. And I can't really emphasize enough how important it is to keep the conversation going and also model good drinking behavior. I think it's really important to just continuously, almost every week, talk about this.